So, cross-compiling temporary tools. And this just tells you a little bit about this stage. And also remember to check LFS is set. So let's do that before we can carry on. Okay, so the first package we're going to build is M4. Extract it, change into it, and start compiling it. Build it. And install it. And that's M4 done. Move on to end curses next. So we've got a change to make, and then we run all these commands in to build the tick program on the build host. So this will actually affect the host by the looks of it, so that's something to bear in mind. To make commands here. That's done, so we can go back, run this configure command, and now build the package. So that's built, we install it with this command. And make a little change with that command. And tidy up. Move on to bash. Configure the build. Now build bash. install it. And finally, we'll make a link for any programs that use SH for a shell. So we'll tidy that up. Move on to the next package, which is core utils. Configure it. Build it. And install. And finally, we've got some commands to move programs into various new locations. So that's core utils. And the next package we've got is diffutils. So we run in the configure. Build a package. And install it. And that's diffutils done. Move on to file. So again, it looks like we're going to build part of the file. Before we actually build a package. So we're creating a temporary copy of the file command with these commands. Now we'll do the actual configure for the final build, or sorry, the build of this part of the section anyway. Install it and remove another libtool archive, and that's file complete. Now I go to find utils. figure. Build it. Install it. So let's find your tools done. Next one we've got is Gork. So we've got a sed. Configure build. Compile it. And install it. And that's Gork done. So grep. Again, a configure command. Oops, that's got pasted in twice there. So because there's something gone wrong with this, I'm going to delete this and extract it again and start from the beginning. Okay, it's configured, so let's build it. On my mouse button here. It's built, install it and tidy it up. Move on to gzip. See, these are fairly straightforward. These packages, it's later on that they get a little bit more complicated because they're more finely tuned for the build. Compile it and install, and it's done. So make next. Bigger. Build. And install. Right, so it's make done. We move on next to patch. Pick up. Make. install. Okay, that's done. And move on to sed. Once more, it's a configure. Make install. So that's done. Move on to tar next. Build. And install it. That's tar done. Now XZ. Build it. And install. And last of all, we've got another libtool archive to remove. And now we move towards the end of this part where we rebuild parts of the tool chain again. So the first one we've got is bin utils. So I need to do a little fix here. And again we build the create a build directory and change into it. Run the configure. And build it. Right, so that's built. We'll install it now. Right, I'm controlling my mouse button. It's got it going. And remove some libtool archives and static libraries as well. And that's bin utils done for the second time. So now move on to GCC part two. So once more, we need to extract the package. And change into it. And again, we need to extract these packages and move them into appropriate positions. I'm going to copy all of this because there wasn't much output. So if there is excessive output, I know one of these has failed. And you can see it's done the renaming after each one has been output, after each one's been extracted, so that's fine. Change the default directory name on 64-bit, so that will, you can run this if you're on 32-bit, it does actually check to see the architectures, but there'll be no harm. Whether you run it or not on 32-bit, but 64-bit, you will need to run that. There's another fix there to allow POSIX thread support. Once again, we create a build directory, change into it. Then we've got a nice big configure command again before we start the build, and this is going to take, well, that's about twice the length of the other one, so this could take nearly an hour for me in that case, if that's a true reflection of what happened before. So we'll set that off and wait for it to finish. Okay, that's finished building. That's roughly the same as before, actually. I thought it was going to take a little bit longer, but not a problem. That's good. Now let's install GCC pass 2. And make a symlink to CC, which some packages might use. And we'll tidy up. Okay, so now we're going to move on to entering Trut and building additional temporary tools.